तो दोस्तों नमस्कार, आपका ऑनलाइन स्टडी ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स चैनल में स्वागत है। दोस्तों आज हम क्लास टेंथ के मैथमेटिक्स में चैप्टर नंबर 2 के विषय में बात करेंगे। चैप्टर नंबर 2 पॉलिनोमियल्स के विषय में आज हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट अबाउट द पॉलिनोमियल? पॉलिनोमियल क्या होता है, सबसे पहले हम इसके विषय में समझेंगे। सो डियर, पॉलिनोमियल इज एन एल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ द फॉर्म पी एक्स इक्वल टू ए जीरो प्लस ए वन एक्स प्लस ए टू एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस ए थ्री एक्स क्यू प्लस एंड सो ऑन प्लस ए एन एक्स रेस टू द पावर एन, इन विच द वेरिएबल्स इन्वॉल्व हैव ओनली नॉन नेगेटिव इंटीग्रल एक्सपोनेंट्स इज कॉल्ड ए पॉलिनोमियल इन एक्स ऑफ डिग्री एन, वेयर ए जीरो ए वन एंड सो ऑन ए एन आर रियल नंबर्स। पॉलिनोमियल्स ऑल्सो डिनोटेड बाई आर एक्स क्यू एक्स जी एक्स एसेट्रा। सो डियर, ए पॉलिनोमियल इज इन दिस फॉर्म, दैट इज पी एक्स इक्वल टू ए जीरो प्लस ए वन ए टू, देन पी मीन्स पॉलिनोमियल and x is denoted by a variable, means this polynomial is in variable x. If we write here py, then the polynomial will be a0 plus a1y plus a2y square plus a3y cube plus and so on any raised to the power of n. And this highest power of x is called the degree of the polynomial. So we write the definition of degree of the polynomial. Degree of the polynomial. We will define it as the highest power of the variable in a polynomial is called its degree for example let's px equal to 2x plus 3x cube plus x raised to the power 5. So in this polynomial have variable x and the highest power of the variable is 5. Therefore degree of this polynomial will be 5. Therefore degree of above polynomial will be 5 because the highest power of the variable is here 5, not 3, not 1. This is 5 is the highest. Therefore, degree of the polynomial is 5. Now, there are different types of polynomial. First of all, we discuss about the linear polynomial. Linear polynomial. What is the linear polynomial? A polynomial of degree 1 is called linear polynomial. For example, we say that px equal to
2x plus 5. So this is the linear polynomial. Otherwise, qx equal to only x. This is also a linear polynomial because the degree of the variable is only here 1. So therefore, this polynomial is called linear polynomial. After that, next polynomial is quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial क्या होता है? What about you say quadratic polynomial? A polynomial of degree 2 is called a quadratic polynomial. Example, let us consider a polynomial Rx equal to 2x square plus 3x plus 5. So here highest power of this polynomial is 2, and this is known as quadratic polynomial. Otherwise, let us another example, x square. This is also a quadratic polynomial because the degree of the polynomial is 2. Now next one is cubic polynomial. Cubic polynomial. If a polynomial of degree 3 is called a cubic polynomial. Let us example for this polynomial. X cube plus 3x square minus 7x plus 9. So dear, this polynomial is known as cubic polynomial because the highest degree of this polynomial is 3. It is written as equal to px. Otherwise, we let Rx equal to x raised to the power only 3. So this is also a cubic polynomial. Now zero of the polynomial. What about you say the zero of the polynomial? A real number A is said to be a zero of the polynomial Px if Pa equal to 0. If you put the value of x in the given polynomial and the result is 0, then this is called 0 of the polynomial. This number, a real number, A is called the 0. If Pa equal to 0, then you can say that this is the 0 of the पॉलिनोमियल। नाउ द रिलेशन बिटवीन द कोफिशिएंट ऑफ द पॉलिनोमियल। सो डियर लेट अस ए क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल, लेट ए क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल ए एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस बी एक्स प्लस सी, दिस इज ए क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल इन स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म, देन सम ऑफ जीरो इक्वल टू माइनस कोफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्स डिवाइड बाई कोफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर। इन न्यूमेरिकली वी कैन से दैट इफ द अल्फा एंड बीटा आर द जीरोस ऑफ द पॉलिनोमियल क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल, देन अल्फा प्लस बीटा इक्वल टू माइनस बी अपॉन ए, वेयर अल्फा एंड बीटा आर जीरोस, देन वी कैन से दैट अल्फा प्लस बीटा इक्वल टू माइनस बी अपॉन ए। Let us second a cubic polynomial. A x cube plus b x square plus c x plus d. This is the standard form of a cubic polynomial having zeros. Alpha comma beta and gamma, then sum of zeros that is minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x cube, coefficient of x square divided by coefficient of x cube. That is, mathematically it is written as sum of zero, and zeros are alpha, beta and gamma. Then you can say that alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b upon a, and the sum of product of two zeros, sum of product of two zeros equal to coefficient of x divided by coefficient x cube. Mathematically we can written as alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha equal to c upon a, where c is the coefficient of x and A is the coefficient of x cube. Next, the product of zeros equal to constant term minus constant term divided by coefficient of x cube. Mathematically, we can written as alpha beta gamma equal to minus d upon a, where d is the constant term and a is the coefficient of x cube. So these are formulas for solving some polynomial. This is the first number and this is the second number and this is the third number. Similarly, in this quadratic polynomial, sum of 0 equal to minus b upon a and the product of 0, that is alpha into beta equal to c upon a, that is constant term divided by coefficient of x square. So there are two formulas for the quadratic polynomial and three formulas for the cubic polynomial. So dear, moving for the question of the exercise in 2.1. Let us dear here exercise 2.1 is this. You can see this is the exercise. So what is the solution graphically in this exercise? The graph of y equal to px. This x is indicated that the polynomial in variable x are given in the figure below. For some polynomial px, find the number of zeros of px in each case. It means that the polynomial y equal to px, that means variable is x. Therefore, you will find only the value of x, and value of x from the graph you can find by observing how many cut, that is the intersection point on the x-axis. So dear, part number first, this is the graph, and in this graph whole, this line is not intersect x-axis. Therefore, 0 of the polynomial is 0, means it has no 0. In the part number second, this curve is intersect in one point of the x-axis, because y equal to px means polynomial is given with variable x. So you can observe only x-axis, how many intersection on the x-axis. So here only one intersection, therefore zeros of this polynomial is only one. For part number third, here is intersection points are 1, 2, 3 of the x-axis. Therefore, zeros of this graph is 3. Next, for part number 4. Part number 4 is, this is 2 intersection points. Therefore, zeros of this polynomial is 2. And part number 5, the intersection point of the x-axis are 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, zeros of the polynomial is 4. Now the last part, 6. The intersection points of the x-axis are 1, 2, 3. So once again, the zeros of this polynomial is 3. This is the exercise. 2.1 is completed. Meet you again for next exercise next day.
दोस्तों, हमारे इस वीडियो को अंत तक देखने के लिए आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, और हमारे इस वीडियो को लाइक शेयर और सब्सक्राइब करना मत भूलिए, लेकिन हाँ, हमारे इस वीडियो को कमेंट करना बिल्कुल भी मत भूलिए।